we can provide them a safe environment in their schools and in their communities. Having said that, you know, it's important that this be done with the consultation of the parents and with the teachers at the school.
Physical education has always been part of Ontario curriculum. The recent policy introduced by Kathleen Wynne's government, well, as I said, from grade one, is not something that is supported by NDP directly. They are about what support the high school and grade three and four students being aware about sex education, yes, also about the cybersecurity issues. Let's empower our children to know what's good for them so that they don't get hurt by any of the predators out there. We do support that. That being said, being introduced to sex ed at an early age, is that really the question? Is that really a good idea? And I'm sure on top of that, when Kathleen decided to put this policy into place, she did not consult the parents, the primary caregivers that will actually be answering those questions at home. I've talked to so many parents, especially when I go pick up my son at school. They are concerned. They are like, they don't feel empowered. As a parent, I want to feel empowered that I am being brought into that question when you're making decisions and you're putting policies into place that affects my child, that affects everybody's child in this room. I think as a parent, we all should be consulted on what is beneficial for them and what is not.
A big focus of the Green Party is including the citizens in our decisions, right? Asking citizens what they'd like to see, listening to them, and then creating policies that are in line with what the citizens want. Not just directives from Queen's Park, but issues that matter to parents, that matter to residents, communities, are addressed and dealt with appropriately, include people that make them feel they're a part of the democratic process, which is what this province and certainly this country is all about. And I think it's very important to ensure that our children are appropriately informed to protect their own, to protect themselves. Children spend a great deal of time online, on various platforms. Parents, I know, spend a lot of time trying to monitor that and ensure that their children are engaging in appropriate platforms and are not, you know, not encountering cyber bullies or issues online that they don't want them to, but you can't be everywhere all the time. So it's important that children also understand and know what they need to know that's age appropriate for them and what to look out for. I think there is no value to anyone to simply not know something and become a victim through ignorance. Again, though, not to say that they need to know absolutely everything. Obviously, that's also not appropriate. But we need to realize that society has changed, as Imran pointed out, and that it's not as self-contained and sort of compartmentalized the way it used to be. The internet has opened everything up and makes it possible for our children to come across things that they may not understand or to have other people target them that we certainly would not want them to be targeted by. And we need to give them some tools to assist with those decisions and to be able to come to you properly and ask you questions and feel that they have the knowledge and the ability to protect themselves.